guys, what's up?
And I'm here to do the April Blu-ray DVD update, and it's funny because I literally thought this month was probably going to be the lightest out of all the months, and it didn't quite turn out that way, so it's mainly because of one reason, and it's because I visited a Blockbuster that was going out of business, and I kind of went a little overboard, but what are you going to do? So this first one is actually a DVD that I got for about $5, and I'd seen it at Target, and it looked kind of cool, and it's Carriers, and it's a, guess kind of a sci-fi outbreak, kind of zombie-ish, end of the world type of movie. Yeah, there's like some kind of virus going around, and it's infected majority of the population, and it's kind of like Zombieland in a way that he kind of explains that there's certain rules for when you come in contact with these type of people. So it's cool. I wish there was a little bit more action. I thought there was gonna be. There's a lot of moments where nothing was really going on. I do like the cast. You know, I do like Chris Pine. I do like Piper Perabo. I do like Emily Van Camp. And it was good. It was I wouldn't pay full price for it, but if you can get it for like $5-6, you know, check it out. This next movie, I got at BrandsMart. I got it at FYE. And I've seen it for a little while, and I kind of wanted to see it. I think I had seen Wet Movie 1 pick it up, and I kind of wanted to see it because I hadn't seen the whole thing. And it's Do the Right Thing on Blu-ray, and it's Spike Lee production. So the dialogue was, for the most part, was pretty damn funny. It was pretty good. You know, it looks great. It doesn't look stunning, but it looks good. You know, definitely much better than the DVD. And you know, it's just one of those movies that it just reminds you of the time. I think this came out in the early 90s, and it just had the vibe of an early 90s movie, so it was pretty cool. Yeah, it was a good watch. Finally got to see the full thing. Pretty good movie. Actually, it's pretty damn good movie. Anyways, the next one is a movie that I know nobody has probably heard of this, but I heard about this movie and I saw the cast and I was like, I gotta see it just for the cast alone. And it's Women in Trouble, and it's pretty much a huge female cast, as you can see by the cover. It stars Carla Gugino, Marley Shelton, Adrian Pilecki, Emmanuel Shrieky, Simon Baker, Joseph Gordon-Levitt, and Connie Britton, who is one of my faves from Friday Night Lights. There's actually like 3 people in this from Friday Night Lights, which is kind of crazy. It was okay. This is another one I got at Blockbuster for like $5. It's kind of like a dark comedy with some drama elements in it. You know, all these characters kind of relate. They kind of all come together. It's kind of weird to describe. Let me see if I can get more light this way. I don't know. But, I don't know. It was okay. Like I said, I did really like the cast. But this is one of those that you would definitely would rent or get really, really cheap. Because it's just, it's different. I don't know if I'd watch it again, but we'll see. This next one is a movie I love. I have it on DVD. But, again, I bought it at Blockbuster. And I got this for about, I think $11, and I really wanted to watch it again. And it's The Zodiac on Blu-ray. It's an amazing movie. It's what is it about? It's about the killings that were going on. The Zodiac Killer. It was awesome movie. It's really long, but it's one of those that it's so good. Despite being really long, it's just, it never got boring. You never wanted to just kind of, you know, not pay attention. It's just one of those that the pacing is really, really, really good. And I don't know, it's just a great movie. It gets better every time you watch it. And what's great about the Blu-ray, because I had the DVD, the first original one that came out, and it had no features. And this one has, which is, and I actually watched all of it, and it's, this is a Zodiac speaking. It has, like, all these, it's like a documentary with a bunch of people talking about what happened during the time, people that actually investigated, the Zodiac killer and stuff, and it was really, really interesting, really good movie, looks really, really fantastic. And, you know, if you can get this, you know, I mean, if you already have a DVD, I wouldn't upgrade it, but if you can get it for a great price, like $11 like I did, definitely I would suggest it. This next one, I like the first one, and I wanted to see the second one, and it's Alvin and the Chipmunks, the Squeakquel. And if you like the first one, you'll like the second one. And it stars one of my homies, and I should say he's not really my homie, I don't know the dude, but it's Zachary Levi from Chuck, and that was pretty cool. Yeah, pretty much the same as the first one. Now this one has the Chipettes, which is in the back. The only thing is, I got this at Target for like $24.99. I actually split it with my girlfriend, but I'm kind of pissed because it seems like every week after I bought it, it was like $20, and I'm like, damn it, I should have just waited. But yeah, it comes with the Blu-ray, DVD, digital copy. It looks pretty good. Pretty good movie. This next one is, finally got around to getting it at Blockbuster, like I said, for like about $13, and it's A Serious Man on Blu-ray. This was actually better than I thought it was going to be. It kind of looked like a movie that I would not be into at all, but kind of liked it. I kind of thought it was pretty funny. I don't know, just it's just that this dude's having such it. I know a lot of people said it's hard to describe, and it really is, but it's just about a guy who's having like really, really bad luck, and it's just, I don't know, it's just, it was funny. Like, it's just, you can feel so bad for the guy, and I'm not sure who he is. I'm not sure if I've ever heard of this guy, but I thought he was kind of good in it. I enjoyed it. It was pretty good movie. It wasn't my favorite of all the Oscar Best Picture movies, but I liked it. This next one also got a Blockbuster for about $12, and it's The Invention of Lying. I actually was meaning to pick this up a while back, a long time ago, but it never went on sale, and I don't have the slipcase, which I wish I had, but it was good. It was funny. I don't know, it didn't blow me away. I laughed a few times. I do think Ricky Gervais is pretty funny, and he has this sarcastic humor to it, like sarcastic dry humor, which is kind of funny to me. Liked it, didn't love it, but it was good. It's definitely one of those movies that's, you know, probably better to watch the first time, and then probably the more you watch it, probably won't be as good. But that's just my, that's just what I imagine, so we'll see. This next one I didn't buy. My girlfriend actually bought this movie because she's been wanting to see it for a really long time, and I really wasn't looking forward to it, but I actually surprisingly liked it, and it's The Time Traveler's Wife. And let me tell you guys, this movie, it looks like The Notebook, but it's not. It is actually a lot different than I thought it was going to be, which is really good, because it's you can call it like a half sci-fi, half chick flick, but it was really weird because it's a time travel movie, and it can be confusing because they don't really explain it to the fullest, but it's like Eric Bana, like, in time travel, but it's like he can time travel in the past and in the future, but then there's times when there's a young version of him and an older version of him, and it just gets confusing. But it was actually, I don't know, it was confusing, but it was really one of those movies where it's like I was fascinated by it for some reason. It was just, I don't know, it was surprisingly, I really liked it. It was actually really, for a chick flick, I thought it was pretty damn good, so you should definitely check it out. I know I wouldn't suggest buying it, but if you have a girlfriend that wants to see it, rent it. It's pretty good. Anyways, guys, that was part one of my April Blu-ray DVD update, and I'll see you for part two. Yeah, yeah.